The practice of curing illness and treating injury is an essential skill that produced very few artifacts during its development, and now occupies a small part of our image of early ways. Juan Cepeda is a doctor of pain. He practices traditional medicine on Guam, a large island in Micronesia that once supported an estimated 90,000 native Chamorros. The Chamorros were a hardy, seafaring people who migrated here from islands in the direction of Southeast Asia about 1500 BC. They developed an advanced fishing and horticultural society that flourished here for over 3,000 years until a Portuguese explorer dropped anchor in this bay in early 1521. Magellan's discovery of Guam was the beginning of the end for the Chamorros' cultural system. The Spanish who followed brought new disease and forced missionization that led to 20 years of bitter uprisings, which ended, sadly, in genocide for the Chamorros. Early accounts describe the Chamorros as a robust people who lived in a rigid class society with many well-developed skills. They built unique sailing canoes that astonished early mariners with their speed and maneuverability. And according to one account, they were able to successfully treat disease with their own system of medicine. After 400 years of cross-cultural influence, much of the early medical practices are still in use. Juan has been treating illness for 26 years with both physical and mystical skills that were passed down to him in the unwritten oral tradition. His system of medicine is made up of four parts: strict dietary advice that excludes high cholesterol and alcohol, a rigorous kneading body massage that is intended to restore normal pressure balance in the body, use of his natural power to locate illness and cure it, and use of 16 wild plants that are combined and crushed to make an all-purpose medicine that is administered as a simple, unboiled tea. Juan began his apprenticeship as a curer by collecting medicinal plants as payment to an aging Suruhanu who had successfully treated his wife for a painful swelling that was thought to be caused by the jungle spirit Chautamona. He recalls some of the knowledge he received from the aging Mariano Charferos in 1946.
I promised the old man to collect medicine in the jungle for 1 year. I promised because they helped my wife and she's alive back. So I promised for 1 year. Then I do that. Then after that, I go with him to visit some place and the patient together. So they told me that it's working what it does. So I watching for another maybe 6 months, you know. Then after that, they asked me, if you want like to go with touching people for Suruhanu, you have to do it. Your heart is strong and don't be scared. It's touching the people, respect the people and concentrate. And don't let the people control your hand. If you touch, tell him to spend, but a cure, because that's the one, the power. Look the eyes and be steady and remember, watch the eye moving, keep on open, look straight, power, more open your eye. So that's the one you could concentrate, the eyes and the brain will remove all those scares.
In 1949, Juan became a Suruhanu. And in 1975, Pat McMakin, a graduate student at the University of Guam in Behavioral Sciences, became interested in the Suruhanu cures and chose them as the subject of his master's thesis. He explains some of the facets of Suruhanu curing.
Juan has great confidence in his medicine and treatment and hasn't changed the plant combination or techniques that he learned in 1948. He produces his medicine from a combination of 16 plants that are indigenous to the island. It's difficult to determine the function of each of the individual ingredients. Some of the plants have aromatic qualities, and others are succulent, having moisturizing qualities. Juan knows of over 50 different plants that have specific medicinal effects, but he mostly uses his all-purpose combination to treat patients. Juan has two associate Suruhanos. Upon learning that he felt it was time to pass on his information, they came from other villages to find if they could benefit from observing his methods. Juan became close friends with Miguel Angacta from the neighboring village of Ordat and with Jose Quintaniza, who lives in Santa Rita, a southern village on Guam. Here, Jose on the left and Miguel on the right assist Juan in the cleaning and preparation of the medicine. After the day-long task of collecting the medicine is completed, the plants are divided into equal amounts, carefully cleaned and washed. A lot of care is taken to ensure that any dead plant material or dirt is removed from the medicinal herbs. The cleaning takes a full day and the medicine is smashed on the third day. Juan used to prepare only enough medicine for a few patients at a time because the medicine spoiled quickly in the tropical heat, but now he rolls it into 2-quart tubes and freezes it for later use.